So we just drove by this big ranch that had a whole bunch of sheep. I couldn't get the camera out fast enough to get the sheep. But it was all nice and sunny. And now it looks like it's about ready to downpour. So what are you gonna do? You know? But all farmland through here. We are in Ohio. Where are we at, Mom?
Just got on 68 going to Canton, Ohio.
Canton. She says Canton.
Canton. Canton. It's not Canton. It's Canton.
Canton.
There's a difference in the Canton aisle and the Canton aisle.
Right. Here's a driving by a farmhouse, a little barn. And
do you think if there's any pictures on the Amish farm, you have to look close.
Yeah.
In general.
We might go to this Amish lady and get chocolates and stuff and see if she's open, but I can't videotape her. Because that would be rude. And she probably wouldn't let me anyway. And I wouldn't try because that would be rude. Yes. They don't like it. Why don't the Amish like to be...
It's a religion. You can't have any image.
Yeah.
No image of the family. Yeah. No graven image.
Right. But a picture isn't a graven image.
Well, that's what they get it from.
I have to look that verse up. I mean, people can believe whatever they want. It's not that. It's just...
It's just a little bit different.
Yeah.
No picture
of
the house.
Yeah, people try to say that certain verses in the Bible are biblical. Like, you know, Nicole, she was just talking about the whole no graven image thing and stuff. And just like, yeah, I don't think that's what that meant, but okay. That meant, like, no idol. I'd have to look the verse up exactly, but what I understood is always that it meant no idols.
Like, to an idol.
But you're not worshiping it. You are worshiping an image of yourself. And
it's kind of a twisted thing on it.
My mother used to be all things Amish she knew.
They haven't been there for years and years.
Yeah. I wonder if she'd get upset if I asked her.
No, I wouldn't.
Yeah, I probably shouldn't. There's a, I think it was a doctor's office that just passed or something. There's a big church.
Arlington.
Arlington? We went to Arlington. Did you know that we were in Virginia, Mom? We're in Arlington. Arlington.
No, we're in Arlington. Oh, they say Ironton.
Yes.
Ironton. I can't do my
job. Ironton. Ironton. We gotta go over to Ironton.
Mr. Bill was good at that.
We gotta go over to Ironton. Ironton, Mr. Bill. Ironton. Or, yeah, Ironton. Oh, boy. We got a lot of work to do. But this is a little town that has... We'd go through all the time. When I was going back and forth between Southland and lots of other things.
Oh, there's a flag.
Saw it. Nice little town, small. I'd say the next biggest town to this would be Columbus, wouldn't it?
Oh, well, the next town would be there's two or three more small towns we did before you get to Canton. And you go through three, four towns on 31.
All right, okay. And then you get through there. Is this the town that had the ice cream place in it?
No.
No.
This is the one you don't want. Oh, I think the very first time I did. Oh. And we found the other one. But
well, until they were jerkwads.
Yeah, this is We should point that out. This is a jerky.
Yeah. Green light.
This? I don't know if anybody's seen these. They used to be real popular. But they're drive-through, like, convenience stores. You just drive through them, and you tell the guy, oh, it's going to rain. You tell the guy, hey, I want this Coke, and I want this bag of chips or candy bar or whatever, and he picks it out, and you give him cash, and that's that. I mean, I bet they could use credit card now in most of these places. Oh, this is a pretty church. And nice stained glass windows. But, yeah, they, so that, they don't see them around much anymore. There used to be one in Yipsy, and we called it the, what was it called, the Purple Cow?
The big cow.
Called the cow, because they had a giant cow on top of the building. I don't know if it's still there. It was by this huge church that we used to go to. That was the same church that I thought that the pastor was God. He was a big, tall guy.
And he was only a toddler.
Yeah, and I was like a little kid. And I was like, are you God?
4 years old.
And I think I asked him one time, I said, are you God? And he just laughed. I was like, no. No. Not good. But... so on the way down, I got my first mean comment on YouTube. I was like, somebody watched and left a comment? Yay! I'm excited! And it was a mean comment. I was like, I don't care. You still watched it. And the guy put on there, said something, oh, I don't care, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, dude, if you didn't care, why did you watch? And if you didn't care, why'd you leave a comment? Okay? You obviously did care, because you watched it, and you left a comment.
He just wanted to be,
as my mother would say, would you say, a mean old dude?
Yes. A mean old dude.
Mean old dude.
Need a bird.
Something like that.
Oh, no, yes.
I hope you put this on YouTube.
You put this on YouTube?
I'm planning on it.
You sing it?
If you want, I might. Whatever you want me to edit out, I will. I was trying to get this barn coming up.
That's a barn.
A barn.
It's a nice barn.
What's the story with your brothers and walking around the what they did on the barn?
A silo just like that one you sing.
It was a silo. It didn't have any top to it.
Yep, and they walked down around the very top when there was like, let me see, I was in first grade, Faith would have been in second grade, and Ron would have been in second grade, Ernie would have been in third grade, and Elmer would have been in, fifth grade, I do believe. Because I was in, second grade there. I don't even know the old, but I don't remember for sure. Anyway, my mother saw them hanging, walking around at the very top. She was so scared. And so she went out there and told the boys, they needed to come down right away. And so they came down. And then she had to explain to them they could never do that again.
Why, Mommy?
She was so scared that they might fall.
Well, they could have. They could have really got hurt.
Yes. I don't think those boys ever did that again.
Yeah. Well, those silos are what, like two stories off the ground? Something like that?
More than that.
Yeah, almost, yeah, like three stories off the ground. So you can imagine if you fell from three stories, I mean, people most likely, they live, depending on how they fall and stuff, but they...
If you fall on your head, you won't live.
Yeah, if you fall on your head or your neck, you won't, but you could really get hurt. And it's just not a good idea. It's one of those things,
you can do it doesn't mean you should. There's a church.
What a
church.
I remember they built this bridge.
Built this bridge?
Yes. This is the bridge that we always came to when we were going to Southport.
Oh.
And they building it. It took about 3 years.
It's been 10 years since I graduated from Southland. Did you realize that?
Oh, yeah.
Crazy. It doesn't seem like it's been that long. Sometimes it seems like it's been that long. It seems like it's been a lot longer. I don't know. It just kind of depends. But.
You had been 22.
Yep. 22, and I thought I had the world on them hanging on by their toenails.
I found out you wanted to travel.
No. But I think that's typical, though, for like 18, 20 somethings think that. It's kind of, I think you kind of have to.
When you get about 25, 28, you realize that life isn't that way.
Yeah, you
mother and dad might have two brains.
Well, it's not so much. I don't think it's. I didn't think you guys didn't have brains and were intelligent. I don't. I never thought that. I just. You want to experience things. Positive things for yourself. Maybe some negative things. But you want to experience things for yourself. And you get there and then you realize. You think, oh, I can change this. I can, you know, I can do this. And I think part of that is just as much of a developmental thing as it is learning to walk.
Yeah, it's a developmental thing, that's for sure. As you get older, you developmentally, you decide that this is good to listen to parents. And as a teenager, parents, what are they made for? Just to give me money.
Well, I didn't act like that so bad, did I?
No, because I wouldn't do it in the first place.
I didn't act like that, and she goes, no, because I wouldn't have done that anyway. That's so my mom.
That's me.
You didn't
actually. That's just Dunker.
Oh, Dunker. You didn't give me money, though. Like, you didn't give me an allowance. You just, you would
you
say,
need something?
You want something? You want a pair of shoes? Okay, we'll go buy a pair of shoes. You need a coat? We'll go buy a coat. You want to go do something with your friends? All right, what do you want to do? When are you going to do it? Kind of a thing.
Here's the nasty ice cream place.
Yes, this ice cream place coming up, guys. I can do the Zoom right. We used to come here for years and years and years, every time around, and that ice cream place there. And so what happened was, it was back in spring of 2014. Yeah, because Faithy had went into a coma, and almost left us then, and. We were all really stressed out. And of course, the ice cream people didn't know that. This building's really cool. I don't know what this building is, but it's really cool. Anyway, sorry, ADD there. Faith was in a coma, had COVID, it had all kinds of problems, and she was in the ICU, and it was touch and go. We didn't know for sure. Am I about right?
Yes.
Yeah. So.
We
were going up to Michigan. The boss calls us, her husband calls us and says, "You have to come up to Michigan." Okay, so we'll come. So on the way up here, we packed up the car on the way up here. We stopped at that ice cream place. We always stopped there for almost 10 years, because it's 10 years this year that I graduated from Southland. So we stopped there. And, my mom tells my dad she wants a banana milkshake,
But she wants it with real pieces of banana in it. She didn't want the substitute stuff.
You don't like the substitute stuff?
No.
She don't
like that syrup stuff. But.
And so she got, my dad with his mental illness sometimes can come off a little bit different. And love him to pieces. And he went up to the window and he told the girl that he wanted, he told him, my mom's order, I told him my order, told him Paul's order, we'd already told him, but he told him again, and then he told him his order, and then he kept repeating my mom's order, like, I don't know, 6 times, that he wanted the milkshake with the real banana in it. Well, he was trying to be cute and funny and kind of, you know, a little bit sarcastic, a little bit cutie, whatever, you know, just funny, because that's how he handles when he does a couple things, and he's not the only one that does this, but when he gets stressed, he starts being kind of cutesy. You know, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah. She nodded, yeah. She said, yeah. So, he starts being kind of cutesy and saying over and over again that he wants, real bananas in this milkshake. And I think he had said it like, I don't know, several times since then. So the girl says, okay, I heard you. I'll make sure that there's real bananas in it. So he keeps saying it. Said it a few more times after that. And there was a guy, probably just turned 18 or whatever. And he says, all right, she heard you. She'll put real bananas in it. And my dad just keeps on saying it, that he wants real bananas in it. So finally, this guy gets mad, gets irritated with him. And he says, starts being just a dipwad. And says, and starts repeating it back to my dad. And starts saying, says that he must be hard of hearing, or must be stupid, or must be this, or must be that, and don't even really remember too much exactly what he said. And I wasn't paying too close attention to it. I was just like, okay. And I kind of patted my dad's arm and was like, hey, you know, come on, they got the idea, now stop, you know. And sometimes he doesn't know when to stop. So, but this wasn't his fault. They started calling him all kinds of names and acting really, really rude, and the way he was saying it. And so finally he says to them, what's your problem? And they said, well, you were being highly offensive because you kept telling us to put the real banana stuff in her milkshake. And he's like, okay, that was offensive that I kept telling you to put real banana stuff in her milkshake? Really? That was offensive? And he said, I don't think that was offensive. I think offensive is other words and other things to say and other ways to say things. I said, I think you were being offensive. I know you were being offensive to me because how you were treating me. And I looked at him and I said, who's your manager? And he starts being all smart behind with me. And I said, who's your manager? And he says, I'm the manager. I said, so who owns this place? He said, I own this place. Well, he kind of did and he kind of didn't. He owned it with his mother. And he thought he was God's gift to mankind because he was running an ice cream place. And I've known other people that thought because they were running this restaurant or doing this, they had now descended from Mount Olympus. The car just went, you know. Kirby things.
Car just farted.
So he says that he's descended, that he's like that, and we're like, no, you're not. You're not any good. But I said, well, if you're the boss, if you run this place, and I'm the customer, then I'm your boss. And I was, like I said, we were dealing with a lot of the big family situation, and I went off. Crustacean don't get mad too often, but when she does, bad things happen. What do you think, Mom?
I think that's right.
So I went off on him, and his ice cream was pretty expensive. It was like, these ice, you know, it was about $25, I think, by the time everybody got something and got the good size and got a decent amount, whatever. It was, I mean, we got something. We didn't just get an ice cream cone, you know, we got something special. So she got a shake. Ooh, there's a drive-in back here. But anyway, so I told him, whatever I ordered, I said, I want real nuts in it. I kept doing that, like, over and over and over again. And I said, and I want real cherries. And I just started being just as much of a toodle as they were being. No, that wasn't the right thing to do, and that wasn't the right Christian thing to do, or whatever thing to do. But you know what? Sometimes it just feels good. Not that it's the right thing to do, it just feels good. So, and I continued after we got our food and stuff. Well, Dad got in the car and he was all upset. And Paul got in the car and he was pretty upset. And then my mom got in the car, and she's like, what, talking to him? And I'm out there waiting for the last little bit of stuff, because I told him, I said, don't, you don't need to put up with their stupidity. He said, you just go get in the car and I'll get the rest of this order. So there was customers waiting in line. I said, oh, you don't want to order from them. They spit in your ice cream. And they won't put real food, real stuff. I was mad. I went off. Again, not the right thing to do. So then my mom got out and she talked to him. What'd you tell him?
I told him they were rude.
She just told him you're rude.
We are one of the rudest people on the face of this earth.
Yeah.
As we will not be coming back. We came up every time we went to Michigan, we got ice cream here. And every time we went back to Kentucky, we got ice cream there. That will be no more. You will lose a customer. And if I could advertise this, I would.
So, yeah. Don't be rude. If you work in customer service, don't be rude. I worked in customer service, and I had customers that repeated the same thing over and over again for whatever reason, you know, you just have to be patient and just be like, okay, well, that's fine, you know, I don't care. I had customers tell me, I have guy customers look at my boobs and make comments about my boobage. I mean, it's not appropriate. You shouldn't do it. I just kind of, in most cases, there are cases where it's not, but in most cases, the best thing is just to ignore it. Just do your job and get them out of your hair as fast as you can. Because the more you try to call attention to it, the more they're going to keep on doing it, and then the more they're going to be like, ooh, I didn't get attention from this, I'm going to do it again. No. So yeah, we've gone back and forth quite a bit since then. We went back, well, we went up and down this time, you know, and then we went up for, my uncle passed away, and we went up for Faithy's 1 month, and we went up and down a lot of times. Between the time Faith ended up in ICU, probably went up a good 10 times. And not went back there since. Now, I mean, I'm not gonna go back. If I have a negative experience with someplace, I'll still go back there once in a while. It takes a while. But it depends on what it is, you know? But I you know, you can't be rude. People, you can't be rude. It's pretty through here.
What town is this, Christina?
I don't know. Is it Columbus?
No, it's not Columbus.
Is it Canton?
It's Canton.
Canton. Ooh, this is pretty.
Canton.
The stonework. I thought the stonework was really pretty. But I think even your little Shih Tzus could jump over that fence.
My little Shih Tzus.
Mom, we're on camera.
I'll take that out.
Uh, There's a day spa here.
I don't need gas. I'm gonna get gas here.
You don't need gas.
I'm going to use the
lady on the phone. Your what?
I only used to have gas.
Oh. Van is surprisingly efficient on the gas. Oh, this is cool. This place coming up here.
Oh yes, this used to be a prison.
This used to be a prison, yeah. It's kind of, I wonder if anybody's ever done a ghost story on it or something like that. Most of these prison, old prisons they have. I like this dome looking thing up here.
Yeah, that is a tower. They built
it up.
Very old.
I wonder how old this place is.
No, it's for the army.
Yeah. They haven't seen much of these around here, but...
Oh, there's a big old courthouse. There's a courthouse.
There's a courthouse.
But they had, where the houses were the little peekaboo thing where they could see the soldiers coming. I haven't seen that so much around. Where did we see a bunch of those at? Wasn't it?
Get that.
I'm getting that, yeah.
This is...
No, no.
Yeah. I like the old architecture, but I don't like the old, like, I like the old exterior on buildings, but a lot of these buildings, here's another family video, that where they, I don't know, they needed to do something on the inside of them to make them where they not so cold.
This is 207, yes.
First Community Bank of Kent.
It's a church.
Very spells.
I gotta make a potty break. I have to make a potty first?
Yeah.
Why not? Everybody please.
No.
What did you just say?
I said don't leave that out of the bed. What kind of person you are? I should beat you.
I told you.
No, it's shake. You're laughing. You're gonna move the camera. She's laughing at me.
I told you guys she does that. She goes, oh, no, no, we don't do that.
We don't do. And that's
one of them.
You wanna stop here?
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea.
It's a Slim Jim place.
It's Slim Jims. Jumping gyms.
I thought it was supposed to say Slim.
That's two. Alright. Bye bye camera.